It is an invisible, deadly threat. It is causing almost vast economic destruction. We knew it was coming, but we're caught depressingly unprepared. It is coronavirus, and it is climate change. The two are intimately connected. The COVID-19 pandemic has been a siren call for stronger action in the face of global threats. What has been described as the impact of this pandemic with a series of extreme weather events has amplified this call, providing an alarming sight into the scope of the terrible challenges lying in store as the effects of climate change become more rampant and evident. As you'd expect, emissions have fallen as people drive less and industries grind to a stop. Yes, emissions are falling, but not for long. Back in February 2020, an analysis by the climate group Carbon Brief found that as the pandemic seized hold of China's economy and heavy industries closed, emissions dropped by an incredible 25%. Another analysis in April 2020 estimated that globally last year, emissions could fall by 5.5% from 2019 levels. That figure may seem low, given that fewer cars are on roads and industries have stopped, but with context, it is surprising. Until now, emissions have been reliably increasing by a fewer percent year after year. That is happening even though the world's nations pledged to individually reduce their emissions as part of the Paris Agreement, with the ultimate goal of keeping global warming below 2 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial global temperatures. As a result, the coronavirus crisis also threatens local efforts to meet the climate commitments that have already been made. World Meteorological Organization, or WMO, Secretary General Terri Swearingen has repeatedly stressed that the economic and industrial downturn as a result of the coronavirus pandemic is not a substitute for concerted and coordinated climate action. Additionally, in late May 2020, as COVID-19 was spreading quickly around the Earth, one of the most powerful storms in decades cultivated into the east of coast India. In anticipation, millions were evacuated into crowded cyclone shelters. Many refused to evacuate out of fear of contracting the virus, an unknown number of whom were killed as a cyclone ripped through their crumbling coastal villages. The extent to which the virus was able to spread due to the evacuations has yet to be assessed. So basically, as these two are intimately linked, climate change helps promote the conditions for the emergence of new pandemics and for increasing their lethality. Climate change is a pandemic enabler, a pandemic accelerant, and a multi-pathway crisis engine. COVID-19 is screaming to us that our health and our planet's health are inseparably intertwined. The same conditions that contribute to the climate change contribute to the pandemics. Investing in the mitigation of these conditions yields a double reward. Failure to invest yields an increased risk.